Coming up, we are going to talk about Azure Arc enabled data services and how you choose the right connectivity mode for your hybrid data workloads. I'm here with Travis Wright, Group Engineering Lead of the Azure SQL team. Hi, Travis. How are you doing?
Hey, good to see you, Thomas. How's it going?
Doing great. So in this video series, we obviously talked a lot about multi and hybrid cloud integration for our customers. And I want to ask you, what are the typical challenges customers are seeing when managing their databases and data?
Yeah, it's really become really complicated these days because most enterprise customers out there are doing a lot of different things. They've got their data in public cloud infrastructure like Azure. A lot of them are now multi-cloud. They're doing things in both Azure and AWS, maybe even Google. They've got stuff in their own data centers, of course, and they're now doing even more on the edge. And trying to get your hands wrapped around all of that data, being able to make sure that it's secure, compliant with all the different company policies and government regulations and so on, has really become a challenge. And that's what we're trying to solve here with Azure Arc enabled data services.
Oh, that's pretty cool. So what you're saying actually is our customers obviously love Azure SQL and they love the cloud and they love Azure and they love our PaaS services. But in some cases, they can't really leverage our cloud regions, right? And they probably want to run it in their own data center locations or even at other cloud providers.
Yeah, exactly. Customers may need to run on some infrastructure other than Azure. You know, maybe they have financial commitments they have to make within AWS, or maybe they have government regulations that require them to have the data in country and we don't have an Azure region there, for example. And yet they want that simplicity of the Azure PaaS experience for managing their databases. And they want to be able to have a central point of control for all of their data so that regardless of where their data actually sits, because it has to meet requirements and be in different places, they can still manage it from a central point of control.
And so what are the other challenges you're seeing? I mean, there are much more to that, right?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, if you think about sort of the pace of innovation that's happening these days, being able to keep things updated, right? And whether that's from a security standpoint, to make sure you have all the latest patches or that you have all the latest features available for your application developers to use. And to do that in a way at the scale that we're dealing with data these days is very challenging and oftentimes time consuming. And that's why one of the nice things about Azure PaaS, right, is it's just continuously and automatically updating your database instances for you and you don't really need to worry about it. And, you know, similar things are just built into our PaaS services like automatic backups and the ability to do a point in time restore. There's built in monitoring. And so a lot of the sort of solutions that customers have had to purchase and operate over the years for backups and monitoring and patching and all these kinds of things, those are just built into the PaaS services. So you get them directly from Microsoft right there next to your databases, and it's consistent regardless of where those databases are running, and even consistent from database type to database type so that I can manage things in a consistent way, whether it's Azure SQL or it's Azure Database for PostgreSQL, for example.
We are enabling the Azure Resource Manager together with Azure Arc enabled data services to provide that single control plane and then also bring Azure, actually the Azure services like Azure SQL managed instances to the customers, right?
Yeah, exactly. So let's take a look at some details on kind of what this all means from sort of like comparing PaaS versus Azure SQL managed instance in Azure Arc. All right, so to begin with, let's kind of compare things from a feature standpoint. Right, some of the most commonly used features of the SQL engine are over here on the left. Of course, all of those are available in SQL Server and in Azure SQL Managed Instance up in Azure Infrastructure. But now we're giving you a new option here, which you can run in your own infrastructure, wherever that might be, where you can run Azure SQL Managed Instance in Azure Arc and get that same set of features available to you so that you have a high degree of compatibility between all these different flavors of SQL. But there are some differences when we think about the management capabilities that are provided. You know, SQL Server has, of course, data security features that are built in. Security is so important that we just want to make sure that that is available everywhere. But in terms of some of the management capabilities, there are some differences. If we think about things like how you run Azure SQL in Azure infrastructure, there, you know, it's kind of more or less limitless infrastructure capacity because you're running inside of an Azure data center. In the case where you're providing the infrastructure with SQL Managed Instance in Azure Arc, that's sort of necessarily limited by the capacity of whatever infrastructure you are using. Now, it might be more or less unlimited infrastructure if you're using something like AWS or Azure to run Azure SQL Managed Instance. But if you're running it in your own data center, then it might be limited by the number of servers or racks that you have available to run your Arc-enabled SQL Managed Instances on. Similarly, because you as the customer are providing the infrastructure, you know, you would be responsible for making sure that the underlying hardware and power and networking and cooling and so on is all highly available, as well as the Kubernetes layer that is underneath all of this. Another kind of key difference is in the case of compliance certifications. In Azure, because Microsoft owns and operates everything about the infrastructure all the way up through the services being provided, the certifications are provided by Microsoft. But in the case of when this is running on your infrastructure, the customer is then responsible, of course, for providing those compliance certifications. Now, in terms of data sovereignty, this is an interesting one where some customers have a requirement to have their data in a data center that they own, right? And so in that case, Azure SQL Managed Instance in Azure Arc gives you the flexibility of having your data be located in your data center. In other cases, there are government regulations which require that the data be inside of a certain country boundary. And in the case where there's not an Azure region available there in that country, then this gives you an option to get Azure PaaS-like functionality, but in a data center inside of that country boundary to meet those government regulations. In the case of Azure PaaS database instances, there's sort of these predefined hardware configurations that you can get in terms of VM sizes, a certain combinations of cores and memory and storage and so on. But you get even more flexibility if you want to run in your own infrastructure. You could bring whatever hardware makes sense to you to run those Arc-enabled SQL managed instances. Another key difference is, of course, in Azure PaaS, Microsoft is operating everything for you, right? In the case of Arc-enabled SQL Managed Instance, here we're providing you the software that automates a lot of the management tasks for you, like automated backup and point-in-time restore, automatic updates, and so on. But ultimately, your team members are the ones that are responsible for operating the service day-to-day, and you can call Microsoft support or issue a support ticket request through the Azure portal to have us help you when you need it. And then lastly, a key difference is that our Azure PaaS services can provide a financially backed SLA guarantee because Microsoft is operating everything down through the infrastructure. In this case, where it's running on infrastructure that the customer is providing, we don't offer the same financially backed SLA guarantee. So there are a few differences in terms of SQL Server, which we all know and love for decades, versus how we run things in PaaS, and Arc-enabled SQL Managed Instance is kind of in between the two, right? And it gives you that flexibility, but with some of the trade-offs where you don't get all of the functionality that you would have in being in PaaS in Azure.
This is pretty cool. Again, like as you just mentioned, like giving this flexibility versus like and still running it on-prem. And I think it's really important that everyone here understands like the differences, because each customer can have different requirements and have different scenarios. And so you can really choose the right solution which fits your needs. Earlier, you mentioned actually like different connectivity modes. And so you have an indirect and a connected mode. Can you explain us a little bit more about these connectivity modes?
Yeah, this is a super important thing to understand. You know, what we've found throughout the preview process is that about half of the customers that are planning on using Arc-enabled SQL Managed Instance are going to run it in a secure data environment that does not have connectivity directly back out to the internet, to Azure, right? And so in that situation, customers can't rely entirely upon Azure-based user experiences to operate those database instances. So what we've done is we've built a lot of the management capabilities in a way where you can run them locally inside of those secure data environments so that you can do things like automatic patching. You can do things like automatic backups and point-in-time restore. The built-in monitoring is right there and runs locally. And there is no dependency on a connection to Azure, at least not directly. And so what we've come up with is kind of this flexibility where there's two different connectivity modes. One we call indirect, and the other we call directly connected. And so let's go through kind of some of the key differences in functionality between indirectly and directly connected mode. And in the follow-up sessions, we'll do some demos to actually show the differences in terms of the user experience that you get depending upon the connectivity mode that you choose. So let's start on the indirectly connected side here. So we understand the features and functionality that are built in and are available to you without that direct connection to Azure. And then we'll talk about what additional things you get by being directly connected to Azure. So let's start with HADR. Regardless of whether you're directly or indirectly connected, you can provision highly available SQL availability groups so that you can make sure that your database instances have fast failover times, and you also get read scale out using those availability groups. Now, there starts to be some differences in terms of self-service provisioning. When you're doing self-service provisioning in the indirectly connected mode, you can use a variety of tools. Again, locally, right there inside of your secure data environment. You can use Kubernetes native tools like kubectl or OC. You can also use Azure Data Studio, which is a GUI tool that you can install on your desktop or laptop. And you can use our Azure CLI tool. And of course, most people are familiar with using Azure CLI in a way where you do AZ login, you log into Azure. In this case, we've added an extension to the Azure CLI that allows you to talk directly to the Kubernetes API to take actions against your database instances that are running on Kubernetes locally without having to log into Azure. Now, in terms of elastic scalability, here you can change the configuration of your database instances to scale up or down the amount of cores or memory. And again, here you're just using those local tools of Kubernetes or Azure Data Studio or the Azure CLI. In terms of billing, this is an important one to understand is that, of course, we need to know how much you are using your database instances, how many cores you're using per hour for each of your database instances. So in order to facilitate the billing process, in the indirectly connected mode, we just require that customers periodically export out and upload a secure file that contains the inventory and billing information to Azure. It provides a way for us to accurately bill you for the actual consumption you have of your database instances within that secure environment. In terms of automatic patching and upgrades here, there's not going to be a direct access to the Microsoft Container Registry from this secure location. So the idea is that you just pull those container images from the Microsoft Container Registry, push those into a private container registry, and configure Arc-enabled data services to monitor that private container registry within that secure boundary for the updated container images to be available, and that will trigger the automatic updates of the database instances. Automatic backup and point-in-time restore all happens locally. We want to make sure that in the event that you have a need to restore a database, that there's no need to go out to Azure to get your backup to restore it, right? All the database backups are there locally, so they happen super fast and that you can restore from them super fast because all of that storage is there local in your secure data environment. In terms of monitoring, all the monitoring is collected and built in locally. There are Kibana and Grafana dashboards that we provide to you locally that you can use to monitor the environment. And in terms of role-based access control, here we use Kubernetes role-based access control. So everything is Kubernetes native, and you can log into Kubernetes using a variety of different authentication plugins that are provided for Kubernetes. And as we talked about a minute ago, the inventory is synced up to Azure along with the billing information. All right, now let's go through kind of the same thing, but for directly connected mode. And you'll notice that kind of the key differences are some additional user experiences that you can use. For example, if you're directly connected, you can actually use the Azure portal to provision and to change configuration, such as elastic scaling, go up and down in terms of the cores and memory. And you can also use things like Azure Policy or Azure CLI or Azure Automation to drive some of the behaviors that you see here in this environment by being directly connected to Azure. And then in the case where you're directly connected, you can just have the container images come directly from the Microsoft Container Registry. In the future here, we will enable the archival of backups up to Azure Backup for long-term offsite retention. And it's optional here where if you want to, you can take those logs and metrics which are being collected locally and forward those on to Azure Monitor and Azure Log Analytics for at-scale collection of that data across multiple different environments. And then leveraging some of the features of Log Analytics and Azure Monitor to do things like alerting or at-scale dashboarding and reporting. And then because you're connected directly to Azure, then you can leverage Azure Active Directory for authentication and Azure role-based access control. And that kind of adds another layer of security there and to do so in a way which is consistent across all of your different environments. And then lastly, in terms of our security services, in the future, we'll be adding things like the Advanced Threat Protection and Vulnerability Assessment services. And those will require a direct connection to Azure so we can download all the latest security policies from those services and apply them to your database instances in your secure environment. And there's really just trade-offs here. Obviously, you get more if you're directly connected to Azure, but that may not always be possible. So this gives customers the flexibility to choose the connectivity mode that gives them the most value at the same time that it helps them meet their requirements that they might have in terms of connectivity out to Azure.
Okay. Now, this is really important to have actually that choice. And I see absolutely value add like you get with like being in a connected mode. But then I know from working with different customers in different industries that they actually need to have a basically disconnected or indirectly connected mode when it comes to security regulations or the other scenarios, right?
Right.
So having that choice is really important. And I think as you said, like it's also important to make that choice very early on because as I know, you can't change it yet, right? After you deployed it.
Right. It's not possible to change it yet. You know, we might add that at some point in the future. But for now, this is definitely something you'd want to study carefully, read the documentation, and make the right choice from the beginning so that you get that connectivity set up the way that you want it. Yeah.
Perfect. Thank you very much. So we have obviously more videos coming up where you show us like the user experience from these different scenarios and how it actually looks like, how you can actually deploy it and how you can manage it. But for the users and for the people who are watching who already want to know more, where are the places where you recommend to go if I want to learn more today?
Yeah, I think simply if you just go to aka.ms/AzureArcData, that's probably the best place to get started there. You can kind of learn about things at a high level and then dive in from there into the documentation, figure out how to deploy Arc-enabled data services on your own infrastructure.
Okay, this is awesome. And for all of you watching, if you want to learn more about hybrid and multi-cloud architectures, check out our Cloud Adoption Framework and the Azure Architecture Center.